So, welcome to the Scranton Historic Iron Furnaces. And we rode the train, we went right by over there. You could see the top of the furnace. Actually, we rode by that way. Furnace history. They're doing a iron pouring demonstration shortly at 2 o'clock, so that's why we wanted to make sure we get here. And as you can see, there's plenty of food stuff here, food truck vendors. And oh wow, look at this thing. Be the Lackawanna River. Yeah, I think Lackawanna. This Lackawanna River. Okay. Yeah.
I don't know this area.
Me neither, but sure I think that's the Lackawanna River as well. Of course, we can always confirm with the man who lives here. Yeah. Hungry, so they're getting stuff to eat.
That is Roaring Brook.
Oh, okay, never mind. So it's Roaring Brook.
That's where I'm at. I'm just looking to see what other.
Well, they're doing the pourings here. This is the Scranton Iron Furnace here. Oh wow. Oh, $75, tintype portraits. They'll do actual tintype portraits to make you look like back in the old days. Hear the train nearby. Oh wow, cool. Cool.
Larger drive wheels, drive rods and that. But it's similar in design to those drive wheels. It's a steel tire on a cast steel rim. When that engine rolls down the track, those tires are gonna wear. There's a flange that runs inside the rail, keeps it on track. That'll wear thin after a while. And also you get flat spots that will skid to a stop and slip, climb in a grade. So the first thing we can do when we get those conditions is we cut the whole wheel set up right here on center. It's in a big wheel lathe. And using cutters, we can turn it and reprofile the outer portion of the tire. Once you do that so many times, you've got to change the tire. So that's where we use the ring of fire.
Oh.
We heat that tire up enough to expand
the ring of fire.
Two guys with sledgehammers, yep, one on each side will knock that tire off onto the bracket that I pulled through. And then we can take it right off. Then we'll hang a new tire up there. That new tire now, we bore that out slightly smaller than the rim diameter so that we have to heat that up first to expand it enough. Then we can push it on, and as it cools, it shrinks. And that's what holds that tire on. But now, if we're going to change the tire, we'd add a little bit of air to it. You get a nice hot blue flame. That's how we would run it if we were going to change it. We want to heat it up quickly before the heat soaks into the rim too, so only the tire expands. That's how we change tires on antique steam locomotives.
Oh, cool.
See that?
That is cool.
Well, now, if you look.
Let me see which ones do they have.
Now, this is good. This is roll.
Which? I don't have that one. Oh, the bold one.
Balance,
That is neat to see. I've been collecting these cards.
Oh yeah, well, I got one there.
It says two more here. They have more here.
I fell into a burning ring of fire. Down, down, down. The flame went higher.
Yeah. That was awesome. Vendors here. There's places. Anthracite events. Trademark music, so. Just a small version of what they actually did here up there on the top. And over here there's more of the actual there's a little bit of the iron making process here. Trying to get pictures as well. There's a cross section of what one of these looked like in there. The anthracite blast furnace. I'm trying to see if I can see a good shot from in here. Oh, it's closed off on that side. Most people here are here to watch the iron pouring. I Yeah, well, he explained. $10, you can create something in one of those molds and they'll cast it for you. The poor crew. Parts are flying. Probably doing some kind of safety. There it is. It's trickling through.
Melt the metal in my mark.
That's good, I like that one. Safety briefing still. Got to get ready to start pouring because they got all those molds to do. Get two angles. They're doing the dedication, like they're turning on the actual furnace, but unfortunately I'm doing the train ride, so I can't be here for that, but that's why I wanted to come at least for the pour. There's JP videos over there, videoing on his
they're not the stuff yet.
they pour the first one quick because they got to be up on the 2:30 train. Back to for the trolley museum. Anthracite coal. Us to shove back about 10 feet. Cool. There it is. It's flowing. It's flowing. Cool.
BOTT, my clay sand and sawdust plug, that's my temporary hold of my iron. So I'm gonna wait for my iron to start to fill up, as we call them, the well, from where I just closed up the tap hole to the little slag part where you see sparks shooting out the side. Once that starts to have slag, I might have already said this, but we're also gonna be looking for the presence of iron after the slag, because the slag is always going to be lighter than iron, rise to the top of your molten pool. So now we're going to start to do iron coke charges on the furnace, starting to get the process up and running. So things will be happening shortly. So we should have, I'd say 30 minutes we should be tapping the furnace, okay? Hang in there, guys. We're getting there.
Well, we saw a little bit, but what time is it? Because I got to be back at the 30 minutes.
Yeah,
I'll be tight. So we're going up the stairs now, up to the top of the Scranton Iron Furnace. It's just a lookout area over here. Because I'm probably going to have to leave before they do the actual pour, but I kind of got a sense of what they were doing before when he let out a little bit. But have to be on the, possibly on the 230 trolley to be on, I mean, on this trolley to be then on the other, the railroad. I mean the trolley from the Electric City. A few other people had the same idea. Well, and not too far from is the train. Oh wow, cool. You can actually look down into it. It's about all you can do. Whoa, cool. So the salamander would have probably, that's probably a salamander down there that's left. Yeah, that's what they call a salamander, the remains of a plug. When they shut it down. There's Jay and Matt over there. Jamie's eating. You can pause and read it if you want to. Up into the Lackawanna River. It's sorry, I'm also trying to look up here really quick. The train ride we went on earlier is up that way. Right along that track over there is the train ride along, right beside this wall. Matter of fact, that might be it coming. Mind if I get a picture real quick? A lot to read. And then here's again the yep, there's the salamander still in there. Another salamander. Wow, this is neat. Now this one doesn't have anything. They're giving you a view of each of the stacks. These are the actual stacks would be here. I know they have a name, the actual thing. This one does have the salamander still there. Wow, cool. So three out of the four have the salamander. Yeah, when we were riding by, I could see people here standing up here on the upper levels of the furnace here. This is so awesome. Too bad it was a cloudy day today. But at least it hasn't rained so far, but let me not jinx anything right now. I'm heading back down, hopefully. They haven't begun pouring yet, so. You can see a really good fire from here. They're constantly putting iron and coke in there. It's all pieces of iron and the chunks of what looks like coal is actually coke. Thank you. be done with this one, making steel. So like I said, that building over there with those, see it says US Army over there? They make ordnance over there for the military in that facility still to this day. So I know they do tours of it. I'm gonna have to make another trip back up here and come over. So the trolley is there waiting. Oh, I didn't see what was going on in here earlier too. Oh, okay, I see what it is. This is one of the actual furnaces, I think. Watch.
Thank you. ask us to shove back about 10 feet.
I might have already said this, but we're also going to be looking for the presence of iron after the slag, because the slag is always going to be lighter than iron rise to the top of your molten pool. But now we're going to start to do iron coat charges on the furnace, starting to get the process up and running. So things will be happening shortly. So we should have, say, 30 minutes we should be tapping the furnace. Okay? Hang in there, guys. We're getting there.
We saw a little bit, but hey Matt, you just missed the last one. There's another one coming at three. Over here. Cool. Yeah, see if I can go around and see the actual floor from that. Mm-hmm. Cool. Let's call a crucible over there. Plugged it up. They already got done. So I got to see the pour. Missed the actual them putting into the crucible, but just up there, looking down into the furnace here. Those were the first mold pours that they just did. For $10, you could have scrawled something into one of those molds, and then you were supposed to do it in the reverse.
Slag. Different. Too hot right now for you guys to handle, but you know, this is probably twice, if not, you know, three times the weight of what this is right now. So it'll always float to the top. It'll always tell us when we have iron.